do Japan excursions, which was released by the entire set of Bigley Trees out there. We have with us two senior officials from Japan National Tourism Organization to give a presentation on Edu Japan excursion. I will request Mr. Deepak San and Madam Yoki Turi ma'am, to please present as to what Japan offers in terms of education. Education always had a lot of traveling part of, associated with it. When you observe different cultures, different traditions, you learn a lot. So we have come across an Edu excursion to Japan, whereby students and faculty would be going and understanding the various Japanese universities and exploring the higher education options out there. So it's a kind of a program which the Japan National Tourism Organization has culled out for us. I would request Dr. Ashok Jain to please come on the dais for this session. I would also request Sri Arkivai Sir, Chairperson Rethink India. I would request Sri Aurobindo Saxena, Head Education Practice at Technopark, who would also be presenting in this session. I would also request Mr. N.P. Sudan from Exam Infra to be on the dais. I think some of the people are just joining in, but Deepak-san, we can initiate it off. And I request the Honorable First Secretary from the Embassy of Japan to please be also there on this session. So, because soon after that, we would be having the entire awards and release ceremony. So it would be great if you can preside over here. It would be our pleasure. Mr. N.P. Sudan, sir, please join us on the dais. So over to you, Deepak-san, for a mesmerizing journey to Japan sitting out here in the India International Center.
Good afternoon, everyone. And I would like to thank Rethink to call us upon here for a presentation. I'm not from the educational side. I'm from the tourism board. And I will show you one small movie. And after that, I'll give you my speech.
And I am here at the ferry boat to see the sacred floating torii gate of Miyajima. This is going to be a super exciting episode where I take you all around Hiroshima, Osaka, and Kyoto. Ikimashou. Let's go! Shalom!
On the way to the Itsukishima Jinja is a traditional merchant street that stretches from the harbor to the shrine.
Ah, look at that. Arigato. It is said that Miyajima Island itself was a sacred god, so they were not allowed to build on the ground, so they built it in the ocean. Miyajima is one of Japan's scenic trio. Like me, I'm sure you've seen many images of this famous shrine, but till you see it in real life, you don't realize how dramatic and powerful it actually is.
Hiroshima has a lot of great foods. Okonomiyaki is a specialty here. It is a Japanese-style pancake which you can fill with bean sprouts, pork, yakisoba, noodles, egg, or anything you can dream of. As we all know, an atomic bomb was dropped on Hiroshima during World War II. The exhibit in the Peace Memorial Museum is highly disturbing, but the purpose is not to sadden, but to move all who visit to never repeat the mistakes of the past. The city of Hiroshima itself has been rebuilt into a bustling metropolis that reminds us life is beautiful.
Japan. It is very famous for being a merchant town, and it's full of life and light. And I'm going right in the midst of it. I'm on the deck of the Omega Sky Building, and just take a look at this panoramic view. The scale of it can just boggle your mind. Kyoto is one of Japan's oldest cities. It was once the capital of Japan, and the imperial family lived here. It flourished as Japan's political and cultural center. Kyoto has a long tradition of crafts and arts, and the use of color, especially pastels, is fascinating. There are many Buddhist temples and Shinto shrines here. Spring is exceptional here when the flowers and cherry blossoms are in full bloom, but so are the colors of autumn, when the fire reds and oranges look like paintings. It is one of my favorite places to time travel. Shorinji Temple in Kyoto to experience Zazen meditation. We human beings are born with a pure heart, but over time, that purity gets diluted because of our selfishness that we use to defend our circumstances and positions. Zazen is a form of meditation that uses breathing to expel the impurities from our heart and cleanse our soul and bring us back to our pure self. This Japanese pure spirit is much like the art, the gardens, the buildings depicted on this sliding door. It is very simple and yet powerful and gives rise to Japan's unique beauty. This beauty and simplicity is to be found everywhere in Japan, from their houses, their buildings, their gardens, their aesthetic, their food, and even the natural clothes they choose to wear. I gave you a glimpse of Hiroshima, Osaka, and Kyoto. I hope you liked it. But there's still so much more to discover in Japan, from mountains to beaches, from culture to adventure. So come and find your Japan. When you do, I assure you, you always return. Because in Japan, once is never enough.
From India. We are here. This JNTO is almost 1 year old company here. We have started. We established all over the world. First of all, I would like to apologize that on behalf of Kenichi Takano, our executive director, Japan National Tourism Organization Delhi office, for not been attending this forum. And myself, as you know, is Deepak Singh. And first of all, I would like to ask few questions. Just please raise your hands. And not in terms of tourism, but in terms of education also. That, have you been to Japan? Anyone? Yes, only two. So, do you want to go to Japan?
Yes.
Yes.
I have very less hands.
Yes.
Thank you very much. Thank you. So, I hope everybody raised their hands and thank you very much. As everyone is aware about the relationship about India and Japan and also going stronger day by day, JNTO is working to grow number of tourists from India to Japan since 2005, the number of travelers from India are doubled to 1 lakh in 2005, and in 2017 the number traveler went up to 1,34,400. So as per our Prime Minister Mr. Shinzo Abe, that he said that this Indians tourists are not enough. So when he was visited Gujarat, so Indian student in Japan is increasing day by day also. Family of foreign students and friends can also think to visit Japan. Most importantly, students becomes big fan of Japan forever. People to people exchange programs between Japan and India become active. Then student will visit Japan again and again. Maybe some students will be joining Japan companies. So you are very important for us. Let's study in Japan and let's work in Japan. I would like to share with you our target in 2020. Japan and India set a target number of tourists traveling between two countries in both direction 2020. Its target is 7 lakh. So my target from India to Japan is 3.5 lakh. So I would like to say one thing, that chalo Japan all together. So last but not the least, in Japan once is never enough. So I would like to call Yoko-san to explain you how they are handling the university trips and the other things for students. Thank you very much. Definitely, after this. Thank you.
My name is Yoko Tori, and I'm from Japan Travel Bureau. It's called JTB. It's a travel agency in Japan. We've got offices in India, and I'm from Bhutan office. I would like to start with explaining about our company, JTB, India Private Limited. It's founded in October 2011. JTB is actually famous in Japan. It's the biggest travel agency in Japan. But in India, we're just baby, still 7 years old. And as I said, we have offices in Mumbai, Bangalore, Chennai, and Kolkata. So why Japan? Okay. So from here, it's easy access. Yes, but it takes like 8 hours direct flight from Delhi to Tokyo. And then daily flights are available from here and also Mumbai. And between here in Japan, 3.5 hour difference. And Japan is known as one of the safest country in the world. And
public transportation is everywhere. Like when we meet for the first time, hello, my name is Yoko. My name is Hiroshi. Where are you from? I'm Saitama, from Saitama. What is the nearest station or bus stop? Da, 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 like that. Within that 10 minutes, 5 minute walk, we can get to the nearest bus stop, either bus stop or train station. And Japan has got a lot to offer, from small children to adults. There are many things to see and experience full of everything. For example, this bullet train. There are some museums you can go, or you can yourself can ride this. And people ask me, when is the best season to visit Japan? Do you know the answer? Kobayashi-san. We've got four distinct seasons. I would say any season, please visit Japan. So spring, it's like pink carpet because of fallen cherry blossom petals. And if you see, look at the tree, you'll see again pink flowers, and it's so beautiful. Summer, it's a bit moist, humid. Still, you will enjoy this fireworks everywhere. And fall, of course, different colors of trees. It's so beautiful, green, orange, red, and yellow everywhere in Japan. And winter, yes, it's a bit colder maybe, but you can enjoy skiing, snowboarding. Sometimes, yes, if you go to a place called Hokkaido, you will enjoy powder snow pretty much. And why Japan for students? Okay, so I'm talking about school excursion. There are many things you will experience and also see, and also from experience, exchanging culture and also school exchange, you learn from Japanese students. Some people say Japan people don't speak English, but actually nowadays people study very hard, and we have English conversation class at primary school, from primary school days. So some students can speak good English, and there's no problem communicating. And old people, senior citizens, they don't speak English, but they are very good at heart. So if you, for example, I want to stay students together when you visit Japan, of course, but if you ask direction on the road, there are people very kind and take you to the nearest station, train station, or maybe police box or something, so you don't need to worry about it. And as I said, it's a well-developed transport network. Yes, some parts Japan can be expensive, but like bus, if you use bus, I mean, I'm talking about big bus, big coach for your group, it can be slightly expensive, but you don't need to use big bus, because there are some bullet train and private train companies everywhere, and Japan Rail Pass you can use. And as I said, yes, it's very, very safe country. And also we've got unique culture. When you go to Japan, yes, I know some people want to try this kimono wearing. Yes, we offer that. And tea ceremony. And I think some of you have learned how to do origami. We also offer that kind of lesson too. And accommodation, this is very unique. Yes, we also have hotel type of accommodation. And do you know what this is? It's called futon. Not sleeping on the floor, but we've got
mat called tatami, and we spread futon over tatami and sleep. That is traditional way to sleep. And students enjoy it because in one room, sometimes four students, six students sleep together, right next to each other. So we sometimes offer this kind of accommodation. And this is also a homestay or home visit experience. Also we organize. And last year we took one student group, 30 students went there to a place called Nara, and we experienced home visit. With homestay family, they did some field work, like they were growing some potatoes. So students themselves went to the field and grabbed some potato and cooked with homestay family, and they said they liked it very much. Talking about food, we have variety kind of food. And some people, this is also an question sometimes. In Japan, maybe veg food is not available. Or Indian food, no Indian restaurant. I've heard in Tokyo itself, there are 1,000 at least Indian restaurants. So yes, if you ask a hotel, or if you go there on a tour, of course we only take you to a Indian restaurant, unless you want to have some experience, like going to Japanese restaurant or Korean or some Italian. Those are also available. In fact, in Japan, there are more Italian restaurants than sushi restaurants, so please don't worry. And for activity, we can take you to JAXA. It's like NASA of Japan, and animation museum kind of places, robotics you will also see and maybe experience, and lots. So this is Japan. And these are the actual photos. Some of them I took, like this happy family, Indian and Japanese homestay family, and Indian students and active teachers. And if you see these two students, oh yes, especially this one was wearing yukata, some type of kimono, and she enjoyed it very much. And a lot of interaction happens with students over there. And this group visited one of private universities in Kyoto. Actually, this is Ritsumeika University, and they have got office in Delhi. And these are school students, and this one studies in Japan. And they had a chance to meet an Indian student actually studying in Japan and heard about the story about living in Japan. And I was very happy. Indian students enjoy staying there. So we are JTB, and this is contact number, and address is in Gurugram, and I've got some business card and information on Japan tourism and education program. So please contact me if you're interested. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, ma'am, for giving such a primer into the entire universe of Japan, which is really exciting. And actually, we have been running a program called Edu Japan, and I will request Sapna ma'am from Modern Public School to please come and share her experiences as to what all is going as a part of it. We also have with us Sanjay Bhattacharji sir from Iris World School. They also have an Edu Japan cell out there. So different Edu Japan cells are working in different stages of evolution. So Sapna ma'am would just share the experiences as to, because it's better to listen it from the horse's mouth who are really deploying it on the ground. So what the program is all about, how they are really driving it on their school, how, what is the response of the students at large. So Sapna ma'am, please.
Good afternoon everyone. I'm Sapna from Modern Public School, Shalimar Bagh. EduJapan is a wonderful program. We are associated with Rethink India, I think the time when Rethink India came into existence, and from there only we came across this EduJapan program, and students are very excited about this program. You know, it helps teachers also to learn Japanese language in a way when we are working with the students. We have already invited people from dignitaries from Japan Foundation, and recently we conducted quiz also wherein we gave the literature to the students, the Japanese literature. We googled it and then we were getting literature from Surbhi ma'am and Raghav sir also, and students were very excited. We are going to share the pictures with you sir, with Raghav sir, and you know, there's a group also, WhatsApp group, which is being formed by Raghav sir and Surbhi ma'am, and the schools where EduJapan program is running, all the I think all the schools are there in that WhatsApp group, and they keep sharing the pictures of the activities they do under EduJapan program. It's very learning, it's enriching our experience, it's giving us a lot of knowledge, and there is huge, you know, a long list of activities. In the last presentation, there was a slide where it was mentioned Golden Week. So we celebrated Golden Week, and we are going to have more information about the more events. So it's interesting, it's learning, and thanks to Raghav sir and Surbhi ma'am to give us this opportunity. That's it.
So this is the ever passionate Sapna ma'am who is really driving it through. Just giving you a brief, in fact I will request Dr. Ashok Jain to be on the dais as well to substantiate as to what we are trying to attempt. So Japan hosts one of the finest higher education system in the world. They have around 1,000 odd universities, public universities, private universities, and a host of them. And interestingly, India, while it is having a civilizational connect with Japan, in fact this evening we are going to confer the Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose acclamation for Edu internationalization. He was the one Indian freedom fighter who really thought to really free India by armed measures, and that too from the east. If you we read all across our history, India has been invaded from the west, from the western Indus area. So in fact one of the whom we call as the spiritual monk of India, Swami Vivekananda, he said very emphatically that in our opinion, if all are rich and educated men, one with women, more women are here out here, so if they once go and see Japan, their eyes will be open. So it's a lovely country, lovely civilization. It was all decimated in 1945, but they have built it across one of the biggest and the most fiercest of the, I would say, economies. And the contemporary times, the Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Prime Minister Abe, the kind of relationship and the kind of equation they are sharing. So India and Japan are coming together as strategic partners on the global frontiers. Now this strategic partnership has to unfurl at multiple dimensions. Bullet train is one, that's the external manifestation of it. But education is something which is the underlying globalization, underlying global undercurrent which happens all across. So what EduJapan program is trying is to handhold the school community at large to know Japan, to engage with Japan, and eventually transact with Japan. You will be astonished to know that our SAARC neighbors like Nepal and Bangladesh send more students to Japan than India. It is largely because of there is a disconnect of action. Going to Japan on a visit, it just like mere passport mein yaar ek visa thuk gaya. After that, it doesn't work. Japan is some of the, we had shared an infographic earlier, Japan is the 10th least expensive global edu destinations in the world. When it comes to tuition fee and residence cost, both combined from the others, and the quality. This evening, we are going to launch one very important publication, which Mosaic has come across. It is the Nobel Laureates of Japan. 26 Nobel Laureates of Japan have been profiled. That small country has given in the last 100 odd years 26 Nobel Laureates across areas. So in this program, what we are trying to do, we are trying to create a capacity within the school campus, trying to handhold. Some coordinators are created, the students are enrolled into the program. And as a part of Know Japan, language is one part, because yes, language is a window to a civilization. Their currency, their thought, their motives, their meanings, and also the general knowledge part of it. What is Japan? What are the 47 precincts? As we have states out here, what are the various islands? A general knowledge, the economy, social, political setup, the Japanese culture. We all use all Japanese products. We are proud in using it. So Know Japan. Engage with Japan, as Madam said, the Golden Week, which is a week-long celebration of Japan. Engaging with the Japanese people in India, engaging with the Japanese food, Japanese movies. So that's a kind of exposure which is being given. And eventually transact with Japan. The end objective is let more and more students who are really aspiring for international education explore Japanese university. So EJU is one of their examinations which happens twice a year. The first, Sanjay Godalavat School Kolhapur is one of the, is a member of the EDU Japan network. And they have given the highest number of students. And in fact, Madam Sasmita Mohanty was asking for more students to be enrolled for EJU Part 1. So this is a kind of a daring exploration. Let's write the EJU exam. That's an entrance to Japanese universities. So it's an examination which is held twice a year in Delhi. For if more schools come over, centers can be opened up. Dr. Jain is the president of MOSAI, which undertakes that examination. So the whole idea is, in the light of EDU internationalization, that let more and more schools also get exposed to Japan. We are very excited about France, Germany, the Eurocentric model of it, the westward part of it. But there is an exciting opportunity in the Southeast Asia, Far East Asia. So why not explore that? Because that has a civilizational connect. So as a part of the EDU Japan program, there was a need also from the schools that they want to experience Japan. So we don't want to make it just a tourism trip, flying out, flying in, but we wanted to make it really grueling. Yoko Turi Ma'am is really crafting, curating a very customized program so that 5 to 6 universities, the students are able to visit and witness the kind of educational programs which go over there. So that is why we just released the creator for the EDU Japan excursion. So over there, the idea is linking with the Indian community, the Indian students studying in Japanese universities. So this is a very specialized kind of a tourism, which is for educational purposes. So that was the context I just wanted to add. And sir, if you could add something more, please.
Maybe you have been hearing the word MOSAI, a peculiar word. MOSAI essentially is an abbreviation for Mombusho Scholars Association of India. Mombusho is the Ministry of Education, Government of Japan. And people like us and members of MOSAI have all studied in Japan, in Japanese universities, research institutes, for a minimum period of 1 year. So all of us who have benefited by studying in Japan created this organization in 1986. And our main aim was to say that, look, we members have benefited by studying in Japan. How do we pass on this information, experience to our younger generation? Now let's admit, most of our young people, especially in schools, when they think of higher studies, of course India is the first, clearly. But we also know that higher studies in India, especially in good universities, is so competitive. In the morning people gave us the statistics. Thousands of people try for admission in, let's say, Delhi University, JNU, and so on. But seats are limited. So it's not that our students are not bright. It's just that opportunities are limited. Therefore, students have to, for their career, for more learning, go abroad. But so far, the choice somehow has been UK, USA, recently Australia, these countries. So we thought that maybe the students, the teacher, the management, they are still, Japan is not on their radar, somehow. Partly because the fault of people like us who have not tried to approach the schools, partly because of historical reasons. We don't understand that historically, Japan was one of the first Asian-friendly country. Swami Vivekananda said, I wish every Indian student had gone to Japan. There is a survey which was done by the Ministry of External Affairs, commissioned by the Ministry of External Affairs, Government of Japan, asking how many would like their children to go to Japan for higher studies. 63% people said, yes, we want our children to go to Japan for higher studies. So what is preventing them? Essentially, the familiarity with Japan, the excitement of Japan needs to be cultivated. So Edu Japan cells do this. Let the students, teachers just get excited about Japan. Start thinking about Japan. We are saying don't force Japanese language on them. Let them themselves say, I want to learn Japanese. That's the only way in which